Okay, if you're watching the hearings today, the government oversight hearings on Libya, this is the room where it occurred, and it's emptied out now. And you know how things always look so different on TV, so much bigger? Well, this is a perfect example. This looks like a little tiny room. Swing the camera around. You see people are setting up for our interview with Congressman Issa. But the room looks so much bigger on television today than it did here. Now, we're about to interview Congressman Issa, and the hearings today were absolutely fascinating. You might want to go on C-SPAN and watch the hearings, but there really is something bizarre going on here. A couple issues. Number one is the security of our consulate in Benghazi, and with 2020 hindsight, we go back and review it to see what we need to do better or differently in the future. Another issue is Al-Qaeda. Is Al-Qaeda back? Is it empowered? Is it growing? It's another important issue. And the third one is the administration responses. Something very unusual, maybe borderline on peculiar, that the administration was trying to shove this whole YouTube protest story essentially into the media so the media would go with it. If you were on the conference call last night from the State Department and Fox was excluded, don't ask why. But I have the transcript of it, is what the State Department says is that from the very beginning, there was no sign of any protest. That's what the senior person at the State Department is saying, is that there was no protest, that there was just suddenly an attack. So where the administration came up with this YouTube protest story is beyond me, but more importantly is why did they continue to push it in light of the fact that their own State Department has the facts contrary to that, and even the intelligence community we're hearing said there was never any indications of protest, that this was just an attack on our embassy on 9/11 in Benghazi. So, anyway, we're going to interview Congressman Issa, will be right here, and you'll see it at 10 p.m. Eastern on the record.